I'm Dr. Daniel Kantor with MS World, and I'm sitting with Dr. Jack Burks, who is the Chief Medical Officer of Multiple Sclerosis Association of America. Vitamin D has been something that we've talked about for many years now in multiple sclerosis. We heard about various reasons why people are interested in it. One of them is that people have noticed that there seems to be more MS the further away from the equator, either north or south. Now, not everybody agrees with that, but most people do agree with this latitudinal sort of idea, and vitamin D has gotten a lot of interest in MS. Do you have any new insights about vitamin D since this meeting?
Well, I would say 10 years ago, I didn't even recognize vitamin D as a major issue, except that people with more sunshine seem to have less vitamin D, but I thought that was very indirect. And every year, more and more data is presented that would indicate that vitamin D may be an important role in multiple sclerosis. And this meeting is no exception. There are a number of papers at this meeting that are encouraging us to measure vitamin D, make sure people take vitamin D. It seems to be helpful. First of all, it seems to be related to the fact that people who have less vitamin D growing up are more likely to have MS. And now we're getting some data that says taking vitamin D may be more helpful if you have low vitamin D levels. And we're continuing to see that in this meeting. So I'm now using vitamin D on patients on a regular basis.
So, of course, like any medication that you want to start, whether it's a supplement or a vitamin, you want to make sure to talk to your doctor. There can be side effects from everything, including vitamins and other hormones. And so you want to make sure to have this discussion with your neurologist and your primary care physician and find out exactly what level, how many international units of vitamin D you should be taking.